In this video, we are going to discuss the linked list data structure and the algorithm to delete nodes from it. We will see how to delete a node having a specific data. I will give you a line by line simple explanation of all the code that we will be writing in this video. Watch this video till the end as I will also show you visually how to construct logic while writing linked list algorithms. My name is Aditya Shenoy from BrainyThings, where I make programming simple and fun. YouTube statistics show that some of you who watch my videos are not subscribed to this channel, so if you end up liking this video, please consider subscribing. It is free and you can always change your mind in future. Before defining the linked list class, we will first define the node class that will be a part of the linked list. So inside this node class, I will define a constructor by defining the __init function. Apart from self parameter, it will have data parameter so that we can set node.data, that is self.data, is data. This will be the data of the nodes of the linked list. And as this linked list will be a single linked list, each node will have a next pointer. So self.next is none. Initially it will be none, but as the linked list will be constructed, these next nodes, next pointers will be connected to other nodes. So I will execute this, and now we can start writing the code for linked list class. So class linked list, again define a constructor. Apart from self parameter, as we have already covered how to insert nodes into a linked list, we will add nodes to the linked list in the constructor itself. If you are not sure how to insert nodes to the linked list, you can check out the previous videos in this linked list series that I have linked in the iCard above. So apart from self parameter, I will have an array of data points that we will be inserting in the linked list. And initially we will set that self.head is none. To maintain the order of the elements in the array, we have to traverse the elements of the array in reverse. So I will do for element in array and double colon minus one. This will reverse all the elements in the array. So inside this, we will create a new node by calling the constructor of the node class and passing the element. And then we will link new node's next pointer to current self.head. And then we will make self.head as this new node. So these three lines are the code that we use to insert elements at the head or the beginning of the linked list. So I have made a detailed video of how we come up with this and to visualize this code, so you can definitely check out that video. And so by this we have completed the constructor. And so that we can print the linked list object directly by using a print function, we can define the __string function. It will just have the self parameter. We will have a empty result initialized, and we will start with self.head node. And while there are nodes in the linked list, we will append the string representation of node.data to the result list. And after appending, we will proceed with the next node by node equal to node.next. And after all the nodes have been processed, that is when the node becomes none, that is after the last node, we will have return an arrow separated list that will join the elements inside the result list. So by this we have written all the constructor and other functions that will require for linked list. Now we can start writing the code for the delete function. So for that we have to define the function, define delete key, and we have to specify the self parameter. And apart from that, we have to specify the key so that we can delete a specific node having this key. So, and if there are multiple nodes in the linked list having the same key, the first occurrence of that key will be deleted. So we will proceed with this assumption. So if we can visualize the linked list, if we delete a node from between the linked list, that is the normal case where a node that is deleted is between two nodes, and if we delete that node, we have to update the node previous to that so that its next pointer points to the next node, to the deleted node. So we can see, we can visualize that after the code is done. So we will definitely visualize that, but a basic understanding is that we have to keep track of the node previous to the node that we are going to delete. So we have to keep track of a previous as well. So I will initialize that previous pointer to none value, and we have to keep track of the current pointer as well, so that we come to know whether we have reached the current node that matches the key. So initially we will start with self.head. Now we have to iterate while the node is not null, and when the node.data is not equal to key. In both these cases we have to iterate for the next node. If any of these conditions become false, we will see what to do. So inside this, it is very simple. If we just have to proceed with the next node, we have to set the previous node to the current node and current node to its next node, that is node equal to node.text. These two lines are very simple. So we are just setting the current node as previous node and the current node to the next node, so that we can proceed with the next iteration. And there are only two reasons why this while loop will break. First is if this node becomes none, and the second is when the node's data that becomes equal to key. And that means we have found a node which we want to delete. And this case is when we don't find a node, any node that has this key. So we will see that these boundary conditions or these conditions one by one. So first we will see non-boundary cases, that is we have found a node, that is this condition was the reason for this while loop to break. So if node. Now there are two conditions. We have discussed earlier that for deleting a node we have to update its previous pointer. But what if we want to delete the first node in the linked list? In that case, previous will not have any value because there is no node previous to the first pointer, that is first node. So that is a boundary case. So we will see, we will check if previous node exists, and if previous exists, that is the normal condition, we will just do previous dot next is current node's next value. So we are linking the previous node's next pointer to the current node's next pointer, and so there is no node referencing to the current node, and thus technically we are deleting the node, but we will deliberately delete that node after some time. So this linking is correct. We just have to clean up all the nodes that are not referenced by anything. And in the else condition, that means if the code reaches this else condition, that means we are deleting the first node in the linked list. In that case, we just have to do self.head is node.next. That is, there is no node previous to the node, so self.head should point to the second node, the current second node, and that will happen by node.next. And in both these cases, we have to delete the node because that has matched, that was the node that matched the key that we have passed in the function. So that is done. What if this if condition does not become true? So if the node is none, that will happen when after this while loop, all the nodes in the linked list have been processed, like the traversed, but no node with data key has been found and it has reached end of the linked list. In that case, we can raise a value error because that is most relevant error to this condition, and we can say that key not found in the list, so that programmers who use this function can understand why this value error has been raised. So this is how you write the function for delete key. Now let's visualize the code so that we can better understand how and why this code works. So let's visualize this code. Each linked list will have a head pointer, and let's say we have a linked list that has three elements, that is node 1, node 2, node 3, for example. And let's add those nodes. So this is node 1, and there will be two more nodes, node 2 and node 3, and there will be a none pointer, so a none value. And if I link this, we will get a linked list like this. So there are three nodes, 1, 2 and 3. We want to delete some nodes from it. The normal condition is that when the node to be deleted has a previous pointer. So let's delete the node 2. So the code will start by this, like previous is none. So a previous will be created, and that will point to nothing. Like I will denote the none value by pointing to nothing, and there will be a node. So we create a node value that will initially point to self.head, like the node where self.head is pointing. So this is done. Now while node, so node is not none, so that is true, and node.data is not equal to key. We want to delete key equal to 2, so both these conditions are true, not equal to and node is not none, so this will become true. Previous will become node, so I will do this, and node is node.next, so node will become this, node 2, and previous will become this. Now again, while we'll check, while node, so node is not none, so that is true, but node.key is not equal to key. Node.data is 2 and key is also 2, so 2 is not equal to 2 will become false, and it will exit out of the while loop. So the node pointer has the node that we want to delete. It will check for the boundary cases. So if node is not none, so that is good. And if there is a previous pointer, so previous is pointing to a not none value, so this is the normal case. So previous dot next, that is this arrow, will now point to node dot next, that is this node, and there is no node that is referencing this node, even though its next pointer is pointing to this. But from self dot head perspective, this node 2 cannot be reached, because if we follow the arrow, we cannot reach this to node 2. So technically we have deleted this, but still, to free up the memory space, we are doing this node 2. So we will delete this node, and after this function executes, we will delete all the temporary variables like this. And so finally we will get a linked list having two nodes, that is node 1 and node 3. Now let's consider one more boundary case, that is when we want to delete a node at the end of the list. Even though that is not a boundary case, but still we will see, because it has a node previous to it, so it is not technically a boundary condition, but let's see what happens. So again, a previous variable will be created that will point to none value, and again I will denote that by pointing to a nothing, so like this. And a node variable will be created that will initially point to where self.head is pointing, that is node 1. Now while node is not none, and node.data is key, is not equal to key, so we are passing key equal to 3 to delete, so that is good. So previous will point to node 1, so this will go over here, and node will point to node.next, that is this, so it will go over here, and previous will go over here. And for the next iteration, node is not none, so this is become true, and node.data is not equal to key, but node.data is 3, key is equal to 3, so this condition will become false, and it will break out of the while loop, and if node. So node is not none and previous is not none. So it will do same execution like previous dot next, that is this arrow will point to node dot next, that is none value. And we can move this to visualize what arrows are looking like. So node 3 is currently deleted, but technically because we cannot reach node 3 by self.head, and we are deleting the node to free up the space. So we will do this, and the final linked list will look like this with a single node, node 1. So even though this seemed like a boundary condition, like deleting a node at the end of the linked list, but it is not a boundary condition because we only cared about the node previous to that, but not node after that. So this condition, this line covered that condition as well. Now let's see a boundary condition where the node is not present in the linked list. So let's say we pass a key equal to 4 to delete. So again, previous will be created, that will point to a none value. A node will be created that will point to self.head like this. While node, node is not none, node.data is not equal to key. So node.data is also not equal to key. So it will proceed. Previous will become node like this, and node will become node.data, node.next. Now, in the next while iteration, it will check while node. So, but node is now pointing to a none value. So it will break out of the while loop. And this if condition will also become false because node is none, and it will enter the else clause and it will raise value error, that is key not found in the list. And after this value raised, like the error raised, all the temporary variables will be deleted and the original list will not change at all. And thus we have safely covered this boundary condition by not altering the current list. So that is good. Now let's see the final boundary condition where we want to delete the first node in the linked list, where there is no node previous to that, so that previous will become. So let's see that. So previous will point to a none value and node will point to self.head, that is node 1. While node, node is not none, that is true. Node.data is not equal to key, but key is 1, node.data is 1. So this will become false because of not equal to sign, and it will not enter the while loop at all. It will check if node, yes, node is not none. If previous is none, so it will go to the else condition, and it will set self.head as node.next, that is self.head will point to node.next, that is this. And after that we can delete the node, and after the function terminates we can delete all the temporary variables. And after this the linked list will look like this. Head will point to a none value, that means the linked list has no elements left in it. So this is how we cover all the linked list boundary conditions, like the boundary conditions of the delete key function. Now as we have seen all the boundary conditions and we are confident that this code will work, we can go and run this code, and we can create a linked list object by calling the constructor of the linked list class that we have created. And we can pass the same data as we have seen in the example 1, 2 and 3. And let's first print the original linked list so that we can see if the linked list is correctly created or not. So yes, 1, 2, 3 has been correctly created in the right order. Now let's delete the node having key equal to 2 like this. And after that we will again print the linked list. Let's see this. The original linked list will look like this, 1, 2, 3, and after deleting the key equal to 2, the final linked list will look like this. So we have successfully deleted the key equal to 2. Now let's see, by deleting the key equal to 3, I will copy these two lines and change this to 3 and run this. It will look like this. So 1, the node 3 has been deleted successfully. Now let's see what happens if we call node key equal to 4. That will lead to a value error and the message key not found in the list. And so this is exactly the error message that we have passed over here. So this boundary condition is also correct. Now let's change this to a normal condition, that is node 1, and see what happens. You can see a blank line over here that indicates that the linked list getting printed over here is empty. And so we have seen all the boundary cases and non-boundary cases that we have just visualized into actual code. So all the conditions are working correctly. So this is how you write the code for linked list data structure and algorithm to delete nodes having a specific key data. The time complexity of this algorithm is linear, that is O of n, as the node to be deleted can be at the end of the list or not present at all in the list. So we have to traverse the entire list in the worst case. Deleting nodes at the beginning, if used with inserting nodes at the beginning and the end, can construct stack and queue. Stacks and queues are very useful in various applications. Deleting nodes from the middle is also useful, as this makes updating the linked list data structure more flexible than arrays. If you ended up liking this video, please press that like button, comment any feedback that you have for this video or this channel, share this video with your friends. The code that I write in all my videos of this channel is available in my GitHub profile, whose link is in the description. You can connect to me via LinkedIn, whose link is again in the description. If you want to see a line by line simple explanation of data structures and algorithms like this, check out the playlist over here. If you want to learn Python built-in functions along with various Python features, tips, tricks and real project examples, then check out the playlist over here. If you want to see a hands-on game development project, check out the playlist over here. And I will see you in the next video.